Good evening. The government's controversial £12 billion NHS computer upgrade has become a victim of the crisis in public finances. Alistair Darling will use next week's pre-budget report to confirm dramatic cuts to the NHS IT programme in England, a project still years overdue and way over budget. Our political correspondent Simon Harris reports.
It was meant to be a new Labour flagship, an ambitious project to bring the health service in England into the 21st century with computerised patient records and improved patient care. But a single IT system for the NHS has proved a huge technological challenge. There have been delays and rising costs. Now it's to become a casualty of government spending cuts as the Chancellor tries to balance his books.
I do think it is necessary for me on Wednesday to indicate, you know, areas where we are going to cut spending or where we're not going to spend as much as we were. You know, for example, you know, the NHS had a quite expensive IT system that, you know, frankly, isn't essential to the front line. It's something that I think we don't need to go ahead with just now.
Launched by Tony Blair in 2002, it had a price tag of more than £12 billion. The system was supposed to create a central database of all patients' records, allow the digital transfer of x-rays and scans between hospitals and surgeries, and introduce electronic prescriptions. Using fingerprint identification for security, this GP is now able to sit at home and access medical notes locked in the computer at his surgery.
At the moment, it's just a glint in somebody's eye, and several bits of it are up and running, seemingly working reasonably well. But we can't tell how good it could be, and we'll never know if we chop it short now.
Critics of the scheme feared a database which replaced traditional medical notes would be vulnerable to computer hackers, and they pointed to the failure of other government IT projects.
Billions of pounds have been spent, billions of them have been wasted, and actually they've never delivered. And I'm afraid that's true of this NHS IT programme. It's late, it's over budget, money has been spent centrally and it's not delivered on what it promised.
Just how much of the project is being scrapped will be revealed this week, but the Chancellor is thought to be looking for savings of hundreds of millions of pounds.
So, Simon, less than 3 days to go till Alistair Darling's pre-budget report. Any other clues what to expect?
Mary, as well as trying to bring government borrowing under control, the Chancellor will be hoping to give Labour a boost in the polls. So we've heard lots of murmurs this weekend from the Treasury suggesting he may try to cash in on public anger over bankers' bonuses. There's been talk of a temporary windfall tax on the bankers themselves or simply a tax on just the banks. Both have provoked angry warnings of financial institutions moving abroad. So the challenge for Mr. Darling is to be seen to be hitting the banks without damaging the economy. Mary.
Simon Harris in Westminster, thank you. The royal family has issued a blunt warning to Britain's newspapers that it will no longer tolerate them using paparazzi photos. Buckingham Palace has told the papers they must observe their own rules on privacy and not publish intrusive pictures. Jackie Kabler has the full details.
Prince Charles and Camilla filmed spending Sunday at Sandringham. But it's not pictures like this the royal family are complaining about. They've become increasingly annoyed by scenes like this. Photographers hounding Prince William's girlfriend Kate Middleton on her way to work. And it's thought it's the prince who's been the driving force behind this royal warning to newspapers and paparazzi. Princess Diana was followed in a similar way. Many senior royals still blame photographers for her death. Now they're demanding more privacy as they go about their everyday lives.
Queen riding every day, there's, you know, photographers go and take that. Or the Prince of Wales out with his children. Just things like that. They've just had enough. And they've got the law on their side now.
England football manager Fabio Capello made similar privacy demands after being photographed with his wife on holiday. Two newspapers were forced to apologise. The royals' demands will be tested when they gather for Christmas at Sandringham. After the usual official photos at the church, they want to be left alone. But some feel meeting these demands could cause big problems for newspapers.
Sometimes you need photographs to prove the veracity of a story. Therefore, it is essential that sometimes these photographs are taken, because otherwise stories of legitimate public interest may not make the paper, and the public that pay the bill might not get to find out about it.
It seems, though, the royals are determined to get tough on those who invade their privacy.
A media lawyer has now briefed royal aides on their options if they feel intrusive photos have been taken. And it's understood the royal family will, if necessary, consider legal action, both civil and criminal. Jackie Kampler, ITV News at Buckingham Palace.
A nationwide manhunt for the husband of a murdered woman has been called off after he was found in North Wales. Michael Roberts was arrested in Wrexham after a tip-off from the public. Vicky Roberts, his wife of 6 months, was found strangled in the garage of the couple's home in Runcorn on Thursday. Greek police have spent the day battling rioters on the anniversary of a police shooting that sparked the country's worst unrest in decades last year. Thousands marched in Athens to mark the killing by police of a teenager. And the American Defense Secretary Robert Gates has admitted the United States has no idea where the Al-Qaeda leader Osama bin Laden is hiding.
We don't know for a fact where Osama bin Laden is. If we did, we'd go get him.
When was the last time we had any good intelligence on him?
I think it's been years.
Years?
I think so.